Okay, let's start 10 minute challenge. Okay, so hi to everyone. So I'm here to share. So what is in the title? So the idea is to share a bit the story and where we are right now and what is our roadmap in terms of testing event-driven microservices. So in fact, if I do a brief summary where we are trying to move all of our application on the right on a cloud native platform, because it's roughly more robust, scalable, expandable, etc. And we're moving to a global backbone of event-driven microservices on the front end and back end on a series of platforms you can see here. But basically, the case I will share with you today is that when we started moving to the right part, we started to do some big transformation project on the IT system. And if you see on the left, we have to redo completely a parcel management system, evolve it, and replace completely the transport management piece. So as we are a retail company, it's a really critical pieces in our system. And we decided to address those two projects as a build in terms of IT strategy. And so it means that all those applications we targeted to build decoupled microservices for all those applications, so around 20 to 50 microservices. So globally, if we simplified the architecture, we implemented distributed processing. So, and as we relied on event-driven microservices, the majority of the microservices are decoupled with topics. And we have some that have kind of a local data store called external APIs. And in fact, when we started to design the big re-harmonization of this IT system in decentralized and decoupled way, it brings big questions and would say different way of testability from what we were used. And it was really key because we were touching the core of the business, producing parcel, asking the transporter to deliver to our customer, etc. And we have a bit key question, so how to test asynchronous system and dealing with eventual consistency. And then I see a key difficulties we can have in any type of architecture, it's management of test data and test environment. So this is what we will share in the next slides. So the first things we do as we were on a strategy project is that we didn't have time to do all the type of testing. So we prioritize based on the business value at that time. So we decided to focus on functional integration and unit and load tests because as we have retail company, we have a specific peak period with sales and Black Friday, etc., where our system need to cope with a huge volume compared to nominal load. And it means that all the other tests were put a bit in a second priority, for example, security also, because we are talking about backbone services not exposed on the internet. So the requirement we had then for the testability is that we need to have a scalable solution for 20 to 50 microservices, so not one, two, or five. We had 4 weeks to implement something to be working for the project because the components were being delivered. We needed to test in CI/CD through the various environment, reduce the risk, so be able to test as early as possible. And the test also to have value and be used by the teams and to be able to have parallel deployments need to be run fast with reliability and confidence. So what we did is that we designed, so after some iterations, this type of architecture of testing. For example, for the functional testing on the end-to-end business processes, we focused on calling the first microservice or the first event and checking the result at the end. And we focused exclusively on the main cases, edge case and error cases. So we didn't do exhaustive use case testing, etc. on that part. Then more locally, we validated the exhaustive business function for each microservices in a loosely coupled manner for each use case, completely independent from the rest of the system. For integration testing, we wanted to check mainly specific components and availability and resiliency. And here in my slide, there is a lot of questions, but in fact, it was that we didn't need a lot of integration tests. It was more by exception, because in fact, we didn't need a contract testing because we do decoupled services with Kafka, etc. So only if we call external services, we don't have microservices calling between them. And all the job of, I would say, testing the reliability of Kafka, Kubernetes platform, etc. It's not the project team job. It's a job of SRE teams. So we are not doing it inside the project. And then unit tests, it was focused and done mainly by the developer because the other type of tests I shared were done by the QA engineers. It was really focused on ensuring a proper and modular architecture of the microservices and needed to be really fast to execute and reliable over time. So it's a bit standard process, I think. So unit testing and mocking to make sure they're working properly. And then for the load test, we took again the full scope because the load tests, it's not on a specific component that we need to make sure. We need to make sure that if we have, for example, a peak of 1,000 K orders, we are able to process them in a defined time frame for the customer to have the feedback and the shipping. So this is why for load test, we address the full scope of testing on nominal and loaded period to verify where we have I would say the limiting factor. It was not a specific point we wanted to check. So then in terms of pipeline and deployment, etc., if we take a bit the different types of testing we had. So on the end-to-end and component, end-to-end, so it was manual or scheduled because it was done through the whole component. So they were most regularly scheduled at a regular interval. And they were running from all the integrated environment inside CI/CD. So in our context, it's a QA, UIT, staging, production. For the component tests, are they able to run locally and fast for the developer? We were able to run them directly from dev. Unit tests, they are only done at build time, so only in development environment. Then we have only one package that goes through the other environment. And load tests, mainly in staging, because we needed an environment similar to production. And then in terms of strategy or refresh and data management, so all end-to-end tests, we decided to do a refresh from the production environment because we didn't have yet ephemeral test environment. And for all component tests, the tests are themselves creating and removing the test data where they are running. So it enables us to have very fast and independent tests that are running on that part. So we don't have yet a big Christmas tree of the perfect agile testing, but so we see that we focused extensively on end-to-end where it makes more sense for big business function for us to have confidence that even if we deliver a lot of microservices independently, the whole business features are still working fine end-to-end. And we have the core on component to verify all the business functions are done correctly. And unit test is mainly for architecture. And what we avoid is to test the same layers between different types of testing. We try really to keep each layer to a specific, each type of test to a specific layer. And here it's more for information. If you wonder the tooling we are using, we use open source stack for the testing. So JMeter testing, etc. Here it's Mockito and GUnit. So, and what we are looking right now is to really keep looking at building real good this software quality and design because these have a lot of problems after on in testing. So I would say good design avoid a lot of problem and testability issues. We are looking at ephemeral environment, probably leveraging Kubernetes or containers, etc., to have on-demand test environment more reliable and more scalable, especially for the component testing and end-to-end testing. And we are also looking at moving to a more, I would say, a systematic load testing, because right now it's a bit manual and on-demand. And the takeaways we can bring today is yes, a bit like the integration test and all that type of stuff is the question we are regularly asking us is can we avoid testing in the first place, so either by a good architecture or having a solid platform that is regularly tested, you reduce the amount of tests required by the project team so they are able to move fast. So this is something we have really in mind to focus. Then the test requirement, again, it's to really align them on the business and the priority and the context and constraints we have because we all want to do all the layer of tests, etc. But the reality is that we need to deliver in 2, 4 weeks incremental values of those business. So We had to accept to do load tests that are on demand and not regularly executed, etc. And on the automation, mainly test automation or even CI/CDs to say, we don't have time to automate everything. So start with, when we are not unsure about the process, it's even more efficient to start manually. And when you iterate and adapt it over the way, then automate it. And it's something we do a lot for the automation strategy. This is what we applied on the test, for example. So what you see, we started a lot of exploratory ways to test before automate them at scale for this part. And so, yeah, so right now, this is what we are looking at and deploying on the rest of the architecture. So I didn't look exactly at the time, but I hope it was it's still in the timing. So it was a bit of a rush. So if you're interested at the end of Q&A, I will be happy to answer.